So we're one commentator down.
And yeah, it seems. You knocked Jan out, yeah?
Yeah.
B4.
Yeah, maybe B4. So what if I take? Yeah. No, I would have been sort of happy to, but I'm still not sure what I'm aiming for really. I mean, C5, something like this. I mean, I can take F5, but I'm not sure. Okay, here at least I had something to aim for. I mean, I saw this endgame, which I thought would be pretty nice. So, I don't know, maybe this? Also?
Take F4.
Maybe. I don't know, should be okay for black, no? When you get to H4. You know, I was actually intending to play King H1. Then again, I'm not sure if you can just play H4. Knight F5, Bishop F6. Rook G1, King H8. In general, I believe the position is black, fine for black. But okay, anyway. No, I think I'm a little bit better.
We were discussing if maybe King H8 instead of King H7 would make a difference with the idea to have Knight H7.
Yeah, no, I thought about it. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a better square for the knight.
Because then somewhere with Knight G5 you might win a half tempo or something.
Yeah. Also, there were ideas like F4. Oh, maybe not. I mean, I was thinking this queen F3, maybe knight H7, but maybe now I have this and then. Or queen D2, maybe. Like in this position, I was also considering this knight D5, queen F3, H4. And. At H5. It's not so clear, I thought, because if takes, you can give a check.
But if I take on H5 first, then you need check.
Our queen takes H5 first.
That's nice. Yeah, that's very nice. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I didn't see that. Yeah, okay, so this line doesn't work. I mean, if black has to retreat, then I'm a little bit better, I think. But okay, I mean, now it's still nothing special, like...
But I was quite impressed by Rook D1, because I thought...
Yeah, I mean, you kind of wanna...
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm not sure it's objectively so impressive, but I was very happy to make the move.
Yeah, because practically, somehow it's a very good prophylactic, yeah? You kind of anticipate this EDC, DC5 counterplay.
Yeah.
And it's not so easy for black to make a move after Rook D1.
Yeah. Maybe I should have tried to play like this or something. But it's not so easy to make progress. I mean, the rook goes to A2 and...
Yeah, of course.
And wait, yeah.
Yeah, that was my question actually, that after rook D6 on move 32, could black go rook A8? Because I thought it's a principal move.
Yeah. I was very unsure about this actually.
If take?
Take, yeah.
Yeah, and then there are all kinds of with rook a2 and rook a1. Okay, rook a2, for example, there was a line.
Bishop d3.
Yeah. Yeah, and h4.
Yeah, and bishop. No, rook b6.
Yeah, then h takes g3, rook d2, with the idea knight h2 perpetual check. But if I start with rook d2, you have bishop f1. No, it's like this, yeah. Rook b6, hg. If I start with knight h2, you have e5. hg.
Uh-huh, so, yeah, okay,
if
so...
If I start like this, then you have e5, followed by bishop e4.
But
if I start with rook d2, then...
Check everything with rook
d2. Then already, yeah, then it's low, because with rook d2, you have bishop f1. But like this, it's...
And rook d6, rook d2.
Rook d6, rook d2.
Or check rook d2. Yeah. Wow, I didn't see that.
If knight goes back, you have h3, whatever.
Yeah.
Then h3. Yeah,
yeah, exactly. No, this I saw. I just concluded, okay, rook b6, and it's probably not a perpetual. Yeah, but. Yeah.
No, of course, it was very difficult because if white has, black has 30 minutes on the clock, then you can spend 15 minutes and calculate, but you were quite short on time. Yeah. Like with 10 minutes. It's very difficult. Should you calculate and go down to 1 minute and then maybe it doesn't work and then what to do?
Yeah, exactly. Also, I mean, yeah, but it was a good point. But still, I don't know about knight f1 because I thought it was a trap that rook f6 loses, but maybe it doesn't actually. So yeah, rook a8 was a really nice opportunity. Maybe I have to go like knight. No, knight f1, rook a2, bishop d1, knight f2. Yeah, I don't know, I'm not even close to being better.
Yeah, because this rook e6, rook d8 looked very dangerous for black.
Yeah,
practically
it did.
Speaking.
Yeah, it did. But yeah, king g7, I think, is the only move, more or less. Yeah. And then, but maybe black just holds here actually. Like I couldn't see it after this. So I mean the whole idea was after rook g5 I would take, and so h4 is threatened after, for instance, knight d5. So h4 is forced, and I just thought f6 and knight e4, but king goes to e7 and oof. And there's nothing. Yeah. So maybe this just holds, I think. Okay, I mean, I can do like this. Takes, knight h5, king h7, this. But, I mean.
Of course, it's a huge difference.
Yeah, it's a huge difference.
Yeah. You missed this h4, or that it's possible at all? Yeah, because, or what did you miss?
Well, I was thinking also white could try some h4, bishop d1, knight h5, so basically I don't know what exactly missed, but felt like also a bit tricky.
You missed probably time, because you were down to few minutes here, yeah.
It's the advantage of playing quickly at this point, because, I mean, it's an important decision, like rook g5 maybe makes a draw, and after fe4 I think it's technically lost, just here, I think I just had to choose the right square for the bishop. Like if I go bishop f3, then knight f7 and knight e5. And okay, trade of bishop would be a huge achievement for black. And now of course it should slowly win. I don't think I played very precisely, but I didn't really blunder either, so...
Okay, it looked confident enough.
Yeah, like, okay. I mean, it's very difficult for black to improve at all. So.
Yeah, that's what we also discussed. The only problem white is facing that already everything is at perfect place, how to win? So
yeah,
you just have to play. Yeah?
I just felt like at this moment, yeah, I mean... It all looks very nice, but my rook and knight sort of needs to trade places, because once my knight comes to f5, then black king is in trouble. So I got there eventually, and here I just had to calculate that this... I thought the last trick for black actually was to play knight d6 here, hoping for this. But... If I just trade knights, it's technically winning. So.
Actually, just a question here with knight on f7, because okay, it's already clear that white is winning. But do you actually have a time during the game to think about aesthetic point of view? Because we spotted that there are very few pieces, but almost everything is on the f file. It's quite beautiful.
I thought about it.
Yeah. Of course, definitely you have more pleasure out of it than the black player, but yeah, yeah. Somehow it really looked nice, yeah, that this f file is so occupied.
Yeah, no, it does. Yeah, I mean, the black rook is on e6 as well, so it's very, very compact for sure. But yeah, here the difference is really in activity of the knights. So because of these knights, there are all kinds of tactical tricks, and here at the end I can just go knight d5, and if rook h6, I cannot protect h5, but b-pawn just runs.
Yeah, somehow we trusted you on this, definitely. I mean, yeah. It looked like you got finally this endgame where I was even telling Jan, because we were discussing where did you go wrong, yeah? I mean, it's very difficult, but we felt like Magnus is the person who treats these positions perfectly, and maybe you did just a small inaccuracy, but it's very difficult to highlight where did you really go wrong. It's just very, very difficult if the opponent using every chance and you are also under time pressure. That was our feeling, that practically against Magnus it's very difficult to save this position. How did you feel at that point?
Yeah, I mean, definitely this rook e6, I mean, after black just feeling worse, but it was a pity that during the game I couldn't figure out the rook e8, and that would be the critical moment.
Yeah.
And Magnus, tell us then how you managed to find always these precise moves and put the most unpleasant questions.
I don't know. I mean, I don't think I did anything special, but clearly, like at this point, this plan with rook d1, you know.
You played it after 2 or 3 minutes. I mean, that's why it was
so
impressive.
But I planned that long beforehand. So, I mean, at first I thought the end game is pretty equal, and then because I cannot do anything on the A file, I just rook e8 and rook a8. But then, yeah, I discovered that this plan with the e5 and f4 could be dangerous. But still, I think black can hold, and it's not surprising. I mean, the black position is solid. It should be defensible. But yeah, then you pose more and more questions, and eventually black has to play very precisely, and oftentimes they don't.
Yeah. Well, congratulations for this great technical victory. And I'm not Jan, who can ask many questions. I mean, for me, it's very logical to ask questions regarding the game, but I think we have already analyzed it enough. I was just personally very impressed by this rook d1, because I think that those small moves make actually a huge difference, and also those moves are very, very unpleasant to face when your opponent goes rook d1, and in 2 minutes you think with black, wow, I mean, it's so fine, what should I do? And should I take, for example, computer? During the game we just don't use it. Just after the game was over, I was just curious for a hint that what computer says, and the computer was insisting that after rook d1, e takes d4, c takes d4, knight f8 is the reaction. Okay, but this is not something you would even really consider, because
for sure.
It seems that it gives white a free hand and everything, and according to computer it might be more or less okay for black.
Yeah, which is not surprising.
It's not surprising, yeah, no. But if that's the right way, then rook d1 is just a super move.
Yeah. But it's in your style as well, right? Like,
yes, only I'm not playing already, you know? I could
see you playing in this position, like rook d1.
Yeah, I would have enjoyed, definitely.
You would have had some fun.
Yeah. So, okay, congratulations. Thank you for joining, and good luck for the rest of the games.
Thank you.
Yeah.